Thank you. The The first piece that you just heard is the Concerto for Bass Tuba by Ray Vaughan Williams. It's the first tuba concerto written for our instrument. They didn't really care about us until like the 1950s, and they're like, I guess we gotta write something. Unfortunately, he was British. We don't like the British. My family lived under British rule till like 1983, so we're not cool around here. Yeah, but if there's one tuba piece of literature that you should know, that's definitely it. The next piece that I'm going to be playing is Tuba Sonata by Paul Hindemith. He was a German composer, and he set out to write a piece of music for every single orchestral instrument. Unfortunately, the tuba kind of got like the scraps of like what he had in terms of thematic material. It's kind of weird. I hope you guys don't mind. It's kind of so I kind of need to like undress a little bit, you know. In the recital setting, I watched a recital by Aubrey Ford. He's the principal tuba player of the Baltimore Symphony and UCLA tuba professor. And he talked about how recitals should just kind of be like you guys are hanging out in your living room, you know, enjoying each other's music. I don't really believe in like being super, super formal, if you can tell. So without further ado, we're going to do Paul Hindemith's Tuba Sonata. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome to the second half. Hope you guys didn't get scared away. That was Triumph of the Demon Gods by John Stevens. Not much he says on this piece. The dude seems kind of like a quiet guy, but I hope the piece spoke for itself. That slideshow, by the way, video was actually made by my wonderful and amazing girlfriend, Taylor. So that teeth scene gets me freaked out every time I see the teeth. I'm like, oh, I don't like this. Please, I gotta play it. This next piece is Reflections on the Mississippi. So I'm gonna take you on a trip down the mighty river. There's four movements: Mist, Fury, Prayer, and Steamboat, where we'll finish our journey in New Orleans. So hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Enjoyed the ride. So for this next piece, I've decided to take the Black National Anthem, arranged by a fellow tubist, Errol Rhodes, and put it in for my quartet. It's actually the nation's national hymn. It was composed on Abraham Lincoln's birthday and sung for him for his contribution in what he did for black liberation during the Civil War. I decided today to really kind of focus on the slideshow presentation I have prepared for you. The truth of the matter is that racism is far from over in the United States, and some of us deal with the effects every single day of our lives. The civil rights movement turned 60 years old this year. That's not a long amount of time. And the PowerPoint is going to be pretty reflective of that. There are people whose grandparents, my grandma, my dad's mom, is 98 years old and was born in 1926. That was before, and she immigrated to the U.S. when segregation had just ended. There are people in these photos that are still alive today and who carry these very heavy and charged sentiments towards black people in particular. And this piece of music is kind of the rallying cry of most protests. This was used during the Civil Rights Movement. This was used during 2020, during the Black Lives Matter protests. And sometimes the reality is a little distorted, where we think, you know, just calling somebody a name, where it's just, oh, I'm just calling you, you know, I'm just going to call this person, or just discriminating. But in reality, there's a lot of people who want people who look like me dead. And that's the harsh reality of this. So if you're easily disturbed, they are going to be very graphic images, strong use of language in this recital today. I ask, once we finish playing, we are going to leave from the stage. The slideshow will keep going, and we will come out, and then we will bow, and that's when you guys will be able to applaud. But there will be a moment of silence where you're just going to sit.
Thank you.
Sorry to leave it on such a solemn note, but I wouldn't do that. We're going to have one more piece after that, but I really hope that that kind of gives you kind of a reality of what, you know, African Americans in the United States have faced and continue to face on a daily basis as we still fight to be seen equal in the eyes of all. So without further ado, this is the last piece of my recital titled Old Legend. It will feature the Spectrum Quartet, so a couple of my good friends. It's a fantasy piece, use some contemporary stuff. You might hear a didgeridoo. We'll see what's gonna happen. I'm gonna give my thank yous after this, so don't be expecting that right now. So be right back. Thank you. So much for coming. It means the world to me to have so many people here. I had people fly across multiple states, drive, watching live. It means a lot to me. So I have a couple of thank yous. The first one to my family. Even though I didn't really choose the career path you guys wanted me to, you guys still endlessly support my musical aspirations. And so for that, I'm very thankful. I'd like to shout out my studio. You guys push me really hard every single day, and being around you guys is just awesome. Couldn't have asked for a better group of people to be around. I want to thank my instructor, Gabe. Without you, I don't really think I could be standing here doing this right now. You've really put a fire in me and just make me want to be not only a better musician, but a better person every single day. I'd like to thank my friends for endlessly hyping me up. You guys are the best. Even when I'm not doing the best, I just feed off your guys' energy, so I love and appreciate that. And then I have to shout out my partner, Taylor. You mean a lot to me, and you did so much. She did most of the video work. She was the one who put the program together, and I really couldn't do it without you. So for that, I thank you. I love you so much. Do I have anybody else to thank? I thank myself. I thank Snoop Dogg. He's not known for his punctuality, so like, you get what you get. But besides that, thank you. That's my recital, so.